Brandon and Kelsee have come to make their marriage vows in the presence of God and of this assembly. The uniting of this man and this woman in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort they give one another in prosperity and adversity, and that their love may be a blessing to all whom they encounter. Let us now witness their promises to each other and surround them with our prayers, giving thanks to God for the gift of marriage and asking God's blessing upon them, that they may be strengthened for their life together and nurtured in the love of God. Brandon, will you have Kelsee to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I will. Kelsee, will you have Brandon to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I will. Will you, the families of Brandon and Kelsee, give your love and blessing to this new family? If so, say, we will. Family and friends, all those who are gathered this day with Brandon and Kelsee, will you support and care for them, sustain and pray for them in times of trouble, and give thanks with them in times of joy, honor the bonds of their covenant, and affirm the love of God reflected in their life together? If so, say, we will. Oh, that is pathetic. This is a hold on, I'll be with you guys in a minute, okay? This is a wedding. This is a happy occasion, not a funeral. You're really excited for them, right? Can we try this again, please? Not the walking down the aisle part. You guys did a great job of that. All right, let's try this again. Friends and family, all of those gathered here today with Brandon and Kelsee, will you support and care for them, sustain and pray for them in times of trouble, give thanks with them in times of joy, honor the bonds of their covenant, and affirm the love of God reflected in their life together? If so, say, we will.
We will.
See, now that's more like it. It's nice to have support. Let us pray. Gracious God, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, into the world to reveal your love to all people. Enrich Brandon and Kelsee with every good gift, that their life together may show forth your love, and grant that at the last we may all celebrate with Christ the marriage feast that has no end. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
A reading from 1 Corinthians, chapter 13. If I speak in tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I'm a noisy gong and a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers, and I understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but I do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable and resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. And as for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, Then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of love of these is love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from 1 John chapter 4. Beloved, let us love one another because love is from God. Everyone who loves us is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us and his love is perfected in us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Well, these two have made it pretty difficult on me, but I think you can see we have two really good specimens right here. The male's pretty full through the back. You can tell he's lost a little bit of girth, which means he's going to show pretty well this year. I think he's got some promise in him. The female had a real nice walk to her. She's got a real strong neck, and I think that's going to be going well for her. Made it real hard for me to choose between these two, and I think you can see that anybody would be proud to have these two as part of their family. And if I had to pick one, y'all should turn around. You know, what an honor it is to be with both of you here today. And I'm going to start my message off a little strange, but stick with me here, okay? Yeah, as if that wasn't strange enough, right? When someone passes from this world to the next, we often refer to them as joining the great cloud of witnesses. But I also believe that you both are surrounded by a great cloud of living witnesses today. So I want to ask a quick survey of your family, and I'm going to pull up my calculator here. Brent and Lana, how long have you been married? For the record, she gave one answer, he gave another. How long have you been married?
25.
Okay. Are you sure? Okay. Rick and Paula, how long have you been married? 28. Okay. And Grandma Griswold, how long were you married before Grandpa Griswold died? 49 and a half. We're going to add that half. It counts. And Grandpa McCullough, how long were you and Grandma McCullough married?
18.
And how long have you and LaVon been married?
Or 18.
Okay, great. Yeah, you know, I get my things mixed up here. Grandma and Grandpa Studeman, how long have you been married?
49.
We'll say and a half, too, because it's coming up pretty soon. And Grandma and Grandpa Lane, how long have you been married? 225 years. 225 years. Do you hear that? Do you hear all of that experience? Do you hear the amount of time that these witnesses have had? These are the people who love you almost more than you love each other. These are the people who give witness to what happens when you put Christ at the center of your marriage and you take your vows seriously. These are the people that give witness to what happens when you tough out the rough stuff and celebrate the amazing stuff. These are all people that give witness to what happens when you refuse to give up on one another. And through our time together, Brandon and Kelsee, I can see that you both are the type of people not to quit. because you're both so dang stubborn. You're willing to go through the hard stuff together. And in some cases, it's hard to tell where Brandon stops and Kelsee begins. You know, I love the two readings that you picked out for this awesome occasion. That First Corinthians reading is chosen a lot for weddings, and not that it makes it any less special for you, but many people think that the love being spoken of in that passage is from person to person. But the love spoken in that passage is about from God to us. I'm going to get nerdy for just a moment. The love in the Greek word, the original text, is agape, which is only used when we talk about the love of God. Remember this. God is patient. God is kind. God is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. God bears all things and believes all things, hopes all things, and God endures all things. Brandon, no matter how much you love Kelsee, God actually loves you more. And Kelsee, no matter how much you love Brandon, God loves you more. In the second reading, we are told that since God loved us so much, we ought to love one another. I am no marriage expert, but there will be days when this is easier said than done. There may be days you don't even like one another, let alone love one another. But this great cloud of witnesses, they'll testify to that. But when those moments come that you want to tear each other's hair out, remember this. Brandon, God created Kelsee just for you. Kelsee is made in God's image. And Kelsee, God created Brandon just for you. Brandon is made in God's image. From the very moment that God started to knit both of you together individually, God was creating you for one another. That's really powerful when you think about that. And it's as if God is saying, Brandon, I can't be there on earth, but in order for you to feel my love, I'm giving you Kelsee. And Kelsee, I can't be there on earth, but in order for you to feel the love of God, I'm giving you Brandon. So I asked Brandon and Kelsee to write love letters to one another and to not share them with one another. And I want to share some of those thoughts with you now. Brandon says, never in a million years did I think I would be this fortunate to be getting married to a beautiful woman who is so caring. I think it just must have been destined for us to be together forever. That's God's doing, Brandon. And Kelsee says, you truly are my rock, and I don't know what I would have done if this crazy cattle industry wouldn't have brought us together. I know you are the brother that Carly never had. You are always there for her and treats her like you are her own sister. Brandon and Kelsee, may your love for one another inspire others to believe in love. May your dedication to one another convict people to believe that there is good in this world. And most importantly, may the way you treat one another be proof to everyone that God is at the center of this marriage and your own lives. You two really are best in show. I'm not going to step on your dress, because that would be bad. All right, Kelsee and Brandon, if you would face one another. Kelsee, you can hand your flowers off to your sister there. Brandon and Kelsee, I invite you to declare your vows to one another. Brandon, repeat after me. In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
And this community.
In this community.
I, Brandon. Take you, Kelsee.
Take you, Kelsee.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In joy and in sorrow.
And in joy and in sorrow.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Kelsee, repeat after me. In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
And this community.
In this community.
I, Kelsee.
Take you, Brandon.
Take you, Brandon. To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
It's okay, take a deep breath. From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Take a deep breath. It's okay.
Were you responsible enough to bring rings? All right. Thank you. You just never know.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God of grace, for your love and faithfulness to your people. May these rings be symbols of the promise Brandon and Kelsee have made with each other, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Brandon, take Kelsee's ring and repeat after me. Kelsee, I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, you put that on. Yeah. Here you go. Let's take Brandon's ring. Place it on his finger as you repeat after me. Brandon, I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
In all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Brandon and Kelsee, by the promises before God and in the presence of this assembly, have joined themselves to one another as husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Applause are good here.
There must be a God. I believe it's true, 'cause I can see his love when I look at you. And he must have a plan for this crazy life, because he brought you here and placed you by my side.
Kelsee and Brandon, join your left hands together and receive this blessing. The Lord God, who created our first parents and established them in marriage, establish and sustain you, that you may find delight in each other and grow in holy love until your life's end. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now, my brothers and sisters, the blessed and holy Trinity make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace, now and forever. Amen. We ask that you remain seated. Brandon and Kelsee will come back in and dismiss you by pew. But I think we're done here. It is my honor and privilege and pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Brandon McCullough.